Windows users trying out Linux are often overwhelmed with the difference in appearance of the open source OS, and especially casual PC users are easily discouraged by having to relearn how to do basic tasks like installing software. The makers of Zorin OS want to make this switching process as easy as possible. Similar menus, easy installation of Windows apps, reliable and easy to use. Let's see if Zorin OS is the serious alternative for Windows users many have been looking for. Zorin OS comes in several editions. The paid Ultimate Edition for €39 with more apps and enhanced features. The free Core Edition for most computers. The Lite Edition for low-spec PCs. And the Education Edition with tools for teaching and learning. I've installed the Core Edition 15.3 in a virtual machine, and it wasn't difficult at all. I would say any Windows user could do it. Linux users familiar with Ubuntu will recognize the installation menu, because that's what Zorin OS is based on. The desktop looks simple and very similar to Windows with the taskbar at the bottom and identical desktop icon layout. The start menu with a search bar is also designed like Microsoft's OS. Only the file browser doesn't resemble Windows Explorer, but I don't think it would take most people long to get used to it. Installing software can be done in several ways. The easiest is probably the software store, but the selection is rather limited and only includes native Linux software. But one of the main reasons for not switching to Linux in the past was often certain Windows software not being available on Linux. I know, technology like Wine for emulating Windows software has existed for a long time, but you can't expect casual users to figure out how it works. Most Windows users probably would just try to download an .exe file and find out it doesn't work. Let's see how Zorin OS handles this. I try to install Notepad++, a program that I think doesn't have a native Linux version. Double-clicking the .exe file in Zorin OS automatically launches a software called Install Windows Application. It's assigned by default, as you can see, when right-clicking the file. This tool automatically downloads necessary applications like Wine to run the Windows file. No terminal access needed. When done, Notepad++ installs just like on Windows, and even links the correct icon on the desktop. I think that's very cool, and anyone could do this as long as it works this flawlessly. Unfortunately, it doesn't for all software, and I'm betting some casual users will be confused by the double file systems of Linux and Windows. Wine seems to be emulating the Windows files on a virtual C drive besides the native file system. It's very possible that there are fixes for software that doesn't work right away, but I'm trying to approach this from the perspective of the average grandparent who probably doesn't know how to fix errors themselves. The settings should honestly be easier to maneuver than on Windows, because everything is actually in one place, and not spread out between different user interfaces like currently on Windows 10. Zorin OS can also automatically install drivers for discrete graphics cards to tap the hardware's full potential. This is why it's possible to play games from Steam, a platform that has done a lot for Linux gaming in the last years. The Steam client even has a built-in Windows game support on Linux, but even if that doesn't work, there's also the game manager Lutris, who makes it possible to play Windows and retro games. And if none of these worked, you can still try to install games using Wine as seen before. Another feature that sets Zorin OS apart from other Linux distributions is the Android app Zorin Connect. It allows for remote control of the PC from a phone. It can sync phone notifications to the computer, share files and more. Of course, Zorin OS also comes with the basic software tools like office programs, web browser, photo editor and so on. It's not perfect, but the clean, simple interface of Zorin OS should be able to please most former Windows users, and the upcoming Zorin Grid with remote management of multiple PCs makes the OS ready for enterprise deployment. I probably don't even need to mention that it's of course more privacy respecting than Windows 10. Zorin OS is obviously not targeted at Linux power users, but newcomers to Linux, and it seems to be doing a good job at that. I'll probably try the Lite Edition for reviving an older laptop, and maybe the Ultimate Edition if it's worth the money. As always with recent Linux versions, you can try the OS without installing from a USB flash drive. I hope this provided some good info for Windows users trying to switch to Linux, and I'll see you in the next video.